welcome back to my channel. See children, the simple tip what you can follow is as soon as you get the answer paper in your hand, making use of your five fingers, first draw the table in the answer sheet in the working column. So this will help you. Even when I was a student, I used to do the same thing. If you are getting confused during the examination, usually whenever you see the question paper, you get tensed. And though you know, you tend to make mistake. So as soon as you get the answer paper, quickly write down this table so that your work will be easy when you are going to solve the trigonometric ratio questions. So now we know what is sine. I told you, once when you know the sine value, remaining all the other values, you can write it very easily. So now you know from the previous method what I have taught, you can very easily remember. Sine 0 is 0 and sine 30 is 1 by 2 and this is 1 by root 2 and this is root 3 by 2 and this is 1. And I had told you cos, you can just write the reverse of sine. So I will just write in the reverse order 1 root 3 by 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by 2. And 0. And tan is the ratio of these two, that is sine theta by cos theta. So now tan will be 0 by 1, that is 0. Here 2 will get cancelled, so it is 1 by root 3. And here root 2 will get cancelled and it is 1. And tan 60, that will be equal to root 3. And here 1 by 0, it is not defined. Okay, so then next what you can do is cosec. So when you see cosec theta is nothing but the inverse of sine theta. Cosec can be written as 1 by sine theta. Cosec is nothing but 1 by sine theta. Whatever values you are having for sine, if you are writing in reverse order, that becomes cosec theta. So now we will see what is cosec 0. So it is 1 by 0. So it is not defined. 1 by 0. So now here cosec 30 will be equal to inverse of half, that is 1 by 1 by 2. So that is equal to 2. Then next here you should just reverse the order, reciprocal. So it is root 2 here. And here it will be 2 by root 3. And here it is 1 by 1, that is going to be 1. Okay. Next we will see secant theta. Secant theta, in short we call it as sec theta, which is nothing but the inverse of cos. Sec is 1 by cos. So we will write down the values of sec theta now. So inverse of 1 will be 1 by 1 is same. Otherwise you can just write the reverse order of cosec theta. We wrote for sine, no? The reverse order we wrote for cos. Sine inverse order we wrote for cos. The same way here you can write the inverse order for sec, or you can take the reciprocal of this. Either way you are going to get the same answer. So we will just verify now. I am going to write the reverse order here and then we will just verify. So here it is 2 by root 3. Here it is 2 and this 2 I will write it here and this is not defined. Now we will check whether it is in the reciprocal of cos. So root 3 by 2, if you write in reverse order, it is 2 by root 3. 1 by root 2, that is nothing but root 2 by 1. And 1 by 2 is 2. And here it is 1 by 0, it's not defined. See, so easy it is. Actually, we should know the sine value. Once when you know the sine value for sine value, this is a trick. If you know this, the rest, all the other values you can write down. Now, cot. Cot is the inverse of tan. 1 by tan theta. Okay. So, 1 by tan theta can be written as reverse of the tan theta values. So now cot 0, that will be not defined here. I'll write the reverse of tan now. this is root 3 and this is 1 and here it will be 1 by root 3 and here it is 0. And for tan, I told you tan can be written as sine by cos, sine theta by cos theta. The same way cot also can be written as, it can be written as cos theta by sine theta. The reverse order you can write. Okay. So the reverse order we will just check now. So cos by sine. So 1 by 0. 1 by 0 is not defined. And when you divide root 3 by 2 and 1 by 2, 2, 2 will get cancelled and you will get root 3. And here 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 2, root 2, root 2 will get cancelled and you will get 1. And here also the same way, you can see 2, 2 will get cancelled and you will get 1 by root 3. And 0 by 1 is 0. And sine, you can see what is a sine. Sine also you can write it as, here I have written cosec is equal to 1 by sine. The same way you can write sine is equal to 1 by cosec. And cos theta will be, here I have written 1 by cos theta is equal to sec theta. The same way you can write here 1 by cosec theta will be equal to 1 by sec theta. So these values will be very much helpful for you when you are solving the questions related to the trigonometric ratios. So in application type of questions, if this table is ready for you, it's half of the work is done, only you people have to substitute the values. Hope children, this table is really useful for you to solve the problems. So I hope you people will make use of this table and make use of the ratio whatever I have written it here, and share it with your friends.